Here we go. This is Helmut and Yin for our 2, 3 to 5 minutes of giving you some tips in expanding your business. And the thing we're going to talk today, Yin, is how to use a book as the best, or why would a book be the best calling card, the best business card ever created? And so why should one have, and how can one actually get one?
Well, having a book to your name, to your profession, I think it's almost like saying that you are an authority in that area.
You wrote the book on it.
Yes, that's exactly where the phrase comes from.
Yeah. Okay.
And from young, I think we have been educated from school to always respect books, you know, education, respect teachers, and even right now, you know, in the normal school faculty, right, a professor who does not publish any book or write any textbook on any subject that he's lecturing on, he actually will not advance on the faculty ranking.
Yes, in fact, that's where the saying comes, publish or perish.
Mm-hmm, that's right.
Okay. So we talked, however, a lot how the internet and the social media and publishing videos like we do now here, publishing articles on thousands and thousands of sites, literally, keyword packed with the correct titles and even the same article with different titles. And so anyways, to be seen in the masses there, wouldn't that make a book kind of irrelevant, or is the book becoming less relevant because of that?
Not necessarily. I think the book will, because of that, be even more relevant. Because as you're out there in the community, you show a very involved self. You know, you show that you are out there with people. And when, if you publish a book, compared to the old days where a book writer literally have to visit book publishers one-on-one to sell the books, now the lines of selling books, the ways of selling books through the internet are now numerous, tremendous for a book author.
Definitely. That brings me to a topic of so first of all, having a book in your title is super important, because he wrote the book on it.
That's right.
Okay, now, first of all, there are two ways of publishing a book. One is self-publishing, and one is publishing to a publisher.
That's right.
Okay. And what you just said is basically you want to do self-publishing your book.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm not so sure if the public knows, the people listening to this, that the average book in America or around the world sells less than a few hundred books.
A year.
Yeah. No, period.
Period.
They go nowhere. Another thing is a misconception that books in a bookstore like Barnes & Noble and stuff will make a book selling.
No,
they won't.
No, not true.
They won't at all.
Right.
Because you get one or two books somewhere up there, you know, except if you're Bill Clinton or somebody like that, yes, then you get your book, you know, you get real estate, literally prime real estate, otherwise it doesn't sell. But the main key is, you got to have just having a book in your own office or whatever,
that's
having
right.
it. And of course, if you do it right, one can get tremendous amount of radio interviews with it and television.
That's right.
Yeah, because as you probably noticed, most interviews with people, even on Oprah and stuff like that, it's the guy has a book or a movie out.
That's right.
Yeah, that's how you get on.
Right.
And then what is talked about is not necessarily about the book. You can now talk about anything.
Well, we have our own example here. You wrote a book.
I wrote a book.
Yes, and by doing so, we find that people were actually read the book, or they found about a book through some press releases that we have, and they call us and then say that we want to interview you. So that was actually all done because of the book. Of course, we can be also known as an expert, but I think the book helped tremendously in that area.
Yeah, never mind that the book got me a whole tour of speaking engagements in India.
That's true.
To hundreds and hundreds of people. Made me sales in the amount of thousands and thousands of dollars, which is really that, you know, here's a point. One might or might not make money with the book. You know, like if you ask, in the old days at least, maybe now it's different, Mr. Robert Kiyosaki, the author of the book Poor Dad, Rich Dad, he will clearly say, how much money did you make with the book? Very little, a few thousand maybe, but because of the book, millions of dollars of seminars and consulting
that's
services
right.
have been sold.
That's right.
And that's the same whether you're a doctor or a car mechanic. It's the business you get because of it. There's more data on how one can write a book without writing one yourself, because believe it or not, I don't know what the number is, but it's a huge, it's 90-some percent, all the books on the market are ghostwritten, not my one, but I do ghostwriting, actually not myself, but we have, there's, you know,
lots of
people out there, yeah. So actually, where there is a will, there is a way. And let me tell you something, in a time like an economy like today, you want to use every little tiny advantage to stick out. If it's not a synergy and not everything you use, somewhere along the line, you're just simply losing out. The most money you lose is not the money you waste, but the money
you never make.
You'll never make. All right. And you will lose lots of money by not using all the tools together in synergy. You know, if you don't do that, that's like trying to have a body functioning well and being super healthy and only taking care of the heart, only taking care of the brain, or taking care of two or three things, but then nevertheless leaving out four or five or six other major important things. All right?
Great. Well, let our audience go to our resources and check out more on the book, How to Become a Best-Selling Author.
Yeah, and check it out, and check out other resources about this whole thing too. There's lots of it on the internet. Which you can find out how you can actually become an author, and yes, a best-selling author within 3 to 5 months after having published your book, if that's what you want. All right, let's go for it. Ciao, ciao.
Bye.